Christine has dreamed.
Mm-hmm. I'm Christine Levine, and you're listening to Levine Large.
This is her podcast, this is her show.
I am the matriarch. Okay.
He's not that wrong.
Are we rolling, honey? Mark, yep. Are we rolling?
Yes.
Oh, we are. Oh, I didn't know. Okay, well, hi, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to a brand new season of Levine Large. We have been on hiatus for a little bit because, a variety of reasons. Number one, I had to get a job.
Ooh,
and so now I've been
crazy.
Working. Well, you know, the good news is our rent's paid. Our lights are on. The phones are on. Like, you know.
Totally weird.
Yes.
Everything's coming out Millhouse.
Some shit's finally working out. And I'm still doing comedy. And
also, my computer's broken. There's that one.
Yeah. And then the other reason is because Josh's computer is broken. And so we can't edit the podcast the way we wanted to. And it's been broken for, I don't know, months now, I guess. A couple
and also,
months.
My computer's broken.
It's been broken.
Yeah, and then Christopher's computer's been broken. Yeah, so we've just been... A friend of mine named Jeff McGinley, he's works for a radio station up in Seattle. He sent me a computer, so I'm able to, like, I can get online and stuff like that now. And Christopher can get online. Josh is still fucked.
Sorry,
but
Hander.
That's the thing, though. All
on the
of our
of suicide.
Oh, it's so sad because all of our editing software and everything was on Josh's computer, and he was the one that was in charge of editing it. So. Anyway, we've had technical difficulties, and we apologize for that, but we are on a commitment to... This is what I want to do, you guys. I want to make sure that we do 12 weeks in a row. 3 months, one episode a week. That's what I want to give the people that like
people.
Our show.
The
Sounds
people.
Good.
Like the 10 people that dig us.
That totally dig us.
Can we
zero.
Do that? Can we commit to at least fucking, I don't know,
yeah,
like 3 months?
And I can commit to that.
I've got nothing going on.
Me?
Sure.
God, we're pathetic.
Christopher's oh unbooked Lord. For life.
Like, I've got stuff. I've got stuff that I
do. What do you
got
to do, man?
But, like, I can make time. Don't worry about it.
Oh, busy schedule, I'm sure.
I'm real busy. I've got a lot of stuff going on in my world.
I want to have stuff going on. I'm not making fun of you. I'm sympathizing.
Josh is trying to get a job because he wants his new computer so bad. He's already got the case to it, which I admire, Josh. Good job. You worked your ass off for that case.
I want to build my own computer. It's going to be a lot of money, but you know, I'll work toward it eventually.
Yeah.
And then next summer, I'll work towards a car, and then I'll be good.
Okay, so let's talk about me for a minute. Okay.
Let's just direct the attention, right?
Yeah, let's just do this. Okay, so I have this job now, and I don't know if I told you guys this, but I've been real weird. Like when I go to work in the morning, like I'm real excited about it because
I got a schedule.
So fucked up, right? That's exactly it. I'm so weirded out by like. Oh, and just kind of happy, and I don't know, like I'm making awkward chats with convenience store clerks at 6 o'clock in the morning, where I'm like,
"Yep, punching the clock." Same.
I totally
another
do.
Day, another dime, dude.
Am I right? You high five.
No, I'm doing that. Jobs. I'm doing that.
Waiting for the Powerball, man. Give me some smokes. All right, see ya. See you tomorrow around 8.
On Friday, I said to the clerk, I go, man, can you believe it? It's Friday already, right?
TGIF.
Doing stupid job. Where I'm talking to other people about the commute. I'm already sick of this lady at work telling me about her fucking sister. I'm over it. I've only been there 3 weeks. I swear to God, it's also turning me into like some sort of, I don't know, like a Republican where I'm, you know, fucking hippies get a job. Get off my lawn.
Now you finally see where Auntie's coming.
Yes.
She's been there for a million
years.
Oh,
God, I'm just so crazy. I don't know what's happening to me. So I've also been listening to a lot of Bruce Springsteen because, you know, he gets it.
Does he get it?
Does he?
No, he fucking doesn't get it. You're supposed to think that, though. You're supposed to think that he gets it.
Stupid factory workers think that he gets it. They're like, yeah,
Yeah,
that's
he
me.
Yeah, he's singing. Same, he's dude. Singing to me.
Like a no, he teen get girl it. Listening to One Direction.
He thinks I'm beautiful. He totally thinks I'm beautiful.
About me.
That is about me. You're right. You're
teen
right.
Girl equals factory worker with Bruce Springsteen. That's, yeah, that's hilarious.
That's absolutely what's happening. Hold on. We gotta adjust this volume here. Yeah, that's exactly what's happening. And so I looked up a lot of Bruce Springsteen. Like, I started like reading about him, and because I wanted to know, like, man, he must have had like a really tough life because he's got all this, you know, I don't know. He seems like he's really in touch with some awful shit.
Like Eminem, you know, he's hard, he's tough, right?
Yeah, he's totally. The 8 Mile.
He's 8 Mile.
Okay, so I have a conversation, you know, like my friend L.A. Patty, and I'm telling her about this, and I go, I don't think Bruce Springsteen's ever had a job. I go, I felt like so betrayed. He's just never done anything in his life. And come to find out, on his own Wikipedia page, you know, he wrote that song Born in the USA. And it's actually...
He wasn't even born in the USA.
If I find that out, he's dead. If I find out he's like Canadian, I'm fucking murdering him. He's done.
Cut his throat.
Right? I will cut his throat and send it back to Canada. No, what? I found out that... He was drafted for the Vietnam War, but what happened was that he pretended to be crazy so that he wouldn't get into the army.
How old is he?
He's like 65, 70.
Okay.
You know, late 60s, I think. Anyway, so he was actually drafted, but he didn't get in because he pretended to be crazy.
Like, what kind of, like, he just...
Whoa! I don't know. Maybe he pretended to be gay because, like, back then that was crazy, you know? So
what was the mental condition back then?
I don't know. Anyway, so that's the first thing that I found about Bruce Springsteen that upset me very, very much. As a working American, right?
Working gay American.
Oh, I was so mad though because I found out that he doesn't fucking work, and then he sings a song about like disenfranchised Vietnam vets, and then he fucking pretended to be crazy so that he didn't have to go to Vietnam. That's so insulting. And then I realized I found out more about him, and then he never had a wife and kids in Baltimore, Jack. He didn't go out for a ride. He didn't ever come back. That never happened. He didn't fuck a hooker in Reno. None of that shit ever.
He might have.
He probably fucked a hooker.
Well, I mean, they didn't keep in contact afterwards. Yeah. I'm just saying, I was so, I don't know, disillusioned by him. And then, like, my friend Patty, she was like, well, you know, he was really, he is kind of down to earth and whatever. And, like, he still drives an old truck. And I go,
if you call yourself the boss, I don't think you're down to earth.
No, okay, A, you're not down to earth. But she goes, oh, no, he still drives an old truck. And I go, an antique truck? Is that, like, is his truck really an 89 Isuzu Pup? And he's, like, terrified, like, well, I don't know, maybe this is going to break down while I'm out running errands. Fuck no.
I might not get to the sold-out arena in time. My car broke down. Oh, no.
And then I was like,
I'm not going to make $1 million.
What the fuck am I going to do? Oh, no. She said, well, he still lives in New Jersey. And I go, what? Born to Run was about getting the fuck out of New Jersey. What a hypocrite. He still lives in New Jersey.
All of a sudden, New Jersey ain't so bad when you got a bunch of money.
Yeah, it's kind of sweet when you're doing all right. And then I was like, I go, I don't even know how he gets his material. And I thought, I told her, I go, I bet he's just got like this cousin named Louis Springsteen, who's, you know, he's living
a shit life. He's just,
yeah, poor Louis. And Bruce just calls to quote, check up on him. Hey, Louis, just Bruce calling to see how you're doing. I heard that you...
Oh, man, there's some pretty bad stuff happening, man.
Oh, I heard you got laid off at the mill. Tell me all about it.
Oh man, you know, my old lady left me.
Oh, that sounds terrible.
It was really
wait,
terrible.
Wait. Can you say that again?
What, you're what? You're who left you now?
Yeah. Lady, okay. I don't know what that rhymes with.
I'll figure out something. Don't worry about it.
I got fired at the mill and then my dog died. Oh, I bet that was sad. You didn't clone it? Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, I don't know what I could do if I couldn't clone my dog. If I wasn't so rich.
Oh my god.
If I wasn't so rich that I could clone my dog and also just pay a lady to be my wife if she left me.
I told Patty, I go, oh my god, it's like maybe he just subscribes to like he only gets the Nebraska Times obituaries like and his butler brings them in every day. Sir, your sad stories have arrived. Oh, thanks, Jeeves. Just put them on the gold table. No, man, the other gold table. Are you stupid? No, in the gold table room, dummy. Put them in the gold table room. It just pisses me off so much. Okay. So then she goes, oh, you know, you've got to see him in concert. You've got to experience it. Like, we should go see him in concert. That's what I thought about. So I looked up, is $100 a ticket to go see Bruce Springsteen. That means I have to spend 10 hours in that fucking shit
bargain.
Pit.
Total bargain.
No, it's not a bargain. That's the worst.
I can't wait to make this fake-ass rich dude even richer. So
exactly.
He can tell me about me.
Exactly. So I can't have to work 10 hours in that fucking sweatshop shit pit. That is so... I mean, believe me, I'm really happy to have a job. But, I mean, it's hard physical labor. I am burnt at the end of the day. I'm so tired. And so, just, I have to work my ass off. And then... To pay Bruce Springsteen $100 so I can hear him sing songs to me about me.
Not even to you.
No, about
to every 1,000 other people that you work with.
30,000 other people that are in my same, right? That are all factory workers. Teenage girls in One Direction.
Is Bruce Springsteen just like a really high-end bum?
No, you know what I was thinking? It's like his wife probably like is having like coffee with her girlfriend. And it's like, oh my God, I don't know how you do it, honey. Your husband looks like he dresses like he works his ass off. And she goes, oh, I know. Tell me about it. It's so hard. Like when the Dickies catalog comes, we can't even talk to him. He just goes nuts. And then I was like, I realized, okay, no, then I was riding with Justin, and Justin goes, well, let's look up how much money he makes. He makes about $60 million a year. He's worth about $300 million.
I can't even imagine that much money. That's so fucked up.
Isn't that crazy? I know. And he's just, and he's just a working man. But you know what? Forbes magazine wrote about Bruce Springsteen and said, it really is a credit to this artist, like how good of an artist he is, that he can be rich and famous for 40 years.
And nobody caught on. Nobody's like stormed the stage and killed him yet.
No, that, well, Forbes said that. Said
pulled the gold out of his teeth.
No, Forbes goes, it speaks to like how great of an artist that he could write so much song, or write so much music about this lifestyle having never lived it. And I was like, really? That's yeah, he's great.
I can pretend to be sad.
You could?
Yeah,
all the time.
All the time.
Well, you know, I don't know. I know that just be like Salvador Dali being a painter and an artist, like he didn't actually see every dripping clock that he painted.
He was pretty fucking crazy.
I know he's fucking crazy. But I mean, I understand, like, you don't have to translate.
Wait, wasn't he the guy literal that also life. Did the lobster phone thing? Salvador Dali?
I don't know.
You ever heard of this lobster phone?
All I know is the dripping clocks.
Dripping clocks. He did that all the time,
That's all I know
too.
About that. Yeah, that was kind of his thing.
He used his own semen as mustache wax to get it twirly.
Really?
Yeah.
That's convenient.
That way.
Pretty crazy. Yeah, right?
It's cheaper.
Nearly limitless supply. So, so Bruce Springsteen, though, is a storyteller. Like, no one's trying to bust Stephen King, right?
Because he didn't, you know, he didn't...
You didn't get your legs broken by some lady in the middle of a snowstorm. Yeah.
No. Okay, that's fair. That's what I'm saying.
He's just telling stories.
Right, but he's doing it in first person. I'm saying that, like...
Well, yeah, but I mean...
You didn't escape from a prison with Morgan Freeman. You're crazy.
Stephen King, fuck you. I know that. I get that's what I. That's exactly
but
where I was going.
Mark. I actually agree with you that he's just hoodwinking us on his blue collar.
Oh Oh yeah, that's what I mean. I know that as an artist, you don't have to. You're not required. You can use your imagination. Put yourself in other people's shoes. You can, you know. There's a lot of creative license, and I think everybody should take it and do what inspires them. But for fuck's sake, putting yourself in first person, constantly saying I, and he's telling other people's stories all the time. Nobody knows anything about Bruce Springsteen. You've been listening to his music for 40 years. Oh, Jesus. Ugh. Burn that neighborhood down. What's going on over there?
Gross.
That's terrible.
Mm. At least 2 Chainz actually lives lavishly and raps about it. Yeah. He never sold drugs. He put himself through college playing basketball. But, like, at least he's super rich, and that's all he talks about.
I just mean that there's something about, like, I appreciate some sort of authenticity in an artist. I need to know
if he's getting that many big booty hoes.
He probably is.
He probably definitely is. 2 Chainz is deep, man. Bury me inside the Gucci style.
You know what was funny? Okay, so the final thing, then Patty said, she goes, but you know, Bruce Springsteen puts on a 3-hour show, Christine. And I was like, oh my goodness.
That's 3 hours every week?
Oh my gosh, how does he do it? 3 hours. Like, there's a supervisor. There's some, like, mean-ass, hard-ass screw in the, like, backstage. Springsteen! Clock in! Oh, man.
Oh, man, bummer.
You're doing overtime today. You're going to work 3 hours.
What? Mr. Butt Savage, my wife is having a baby.
No, my baby was going to... I got to take her to France tonight.
She's going
to
leave me if I don't get there in time. She's gonna get on that plane. She's gonna go away forever.
I left my jet on the tarmac, man. I'm double parked. I gotta go. Yes, he's hoodwinking us. He's totally, Mark, you're right. He's just.
He's a real piece of shit.
He's just.
He's a rapist.
Child molester.
God, probably.
Murderer.
You know what? Bill Cosby, like, kind of secretly. Raped no. girls. Yeah. Yes, he does.
Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby.
My main man, because.
Yeah. Wait. Yeah.
No, he didn't.
Puddin' Pop. Yeah, he does it. Nope. Yeah.
I refuse to believe.
On the reg.
He drugs Kids. Women. Drugs them.
Now?
Just, like, plays them. With their pussy.
No, yeah.
He doesn't. He doesn't like, fuck them because his dick doesn't work.
Yeah.
Right now, Bill Cosby could possibly be drugging a lady and.
Probably not right now.
Not right now. I mean, it is like Sunday. Asleep. He's home. Yeah, he's probably in bed.
You can't do it in the day of the Lord.
Yeah. So, but he does touch her nethers. Mm-hmm. That happens. Okay, and then
kids say the darndest things.
Okay, so welcome to the new season of Levine Large. I've been at the river all day. I'm fucking gross, nasty, stink it's river real, funk.
You
shit.
Always hard stink, day. Idiot.
Shut up. There were so many naked people at the river today. I was embarrassed because I wasn't naked. So then, guess what?
Why? Where do you go that has all these naked people? I never see naked people.
Oh, I go to the clothing optional.
That sucks.
I go to the clothing optional beach.
Dude, where do you see naked people? Are there boobies there?
Yeah, there's. There's so much boobies.
Wait. Okay. Kyle,
boobs.
Kyle. You see that girl, BBs?
Shut up. I'm trying to tell you where they're at. They're at Selby Island. That's where we go to the clothing optional beach. And it's really chill and laid back. And there's lots of fucking naked people everywhere. Today was exceptionally naked. Just, you know, clothing optional means you can wear clothes or you can not wear clothes. Nobody cares. But today, everybody was not wearing clothes.
Gross.
And there's a bunch of boaters and dudes that Justin calls turtles.
Turtles.
Because they have like a big belly and a little tiny wiener coming out with their little turtle, and they're like super leathery looking, like tan and weird.
How many people did you see like peeping the little naked kids?
Oh,
probably
this
a
time,
lot, right?
No, this time, gross. No, this time we didn't see any gross dudes peeping naked kids. It was all right. There was a couple naked kids though, but they were with their family and well protected, so everything. But it was a great day. It was super beautiful, and
I don't know what I would
nice.
Do if you
and I was on the water all the time.
I don't know what I'd do if you and Dad took me to a beach and then just get naked.
Yeah, just get naked with your parents. Fucking cool. Great.
Yeah, come on, Josh. Aren't you cool?
I get to stare at my dad's meatballs all day.
Don't you want to
scraggly haired, gross ass, old dude dick? I get to look at that all day.
Yeah, well, you don't have to just look at that. Well, your eyes can go other places, Josh. Well,
no, they can't. I'm gonna move my head, and it's just gonna be like my eyes are just gonna be like moving, and then stop for a second, and then keep going.
That dad rod is just gonna be in his peripheral the whole time.
I'm not saying that I want to, but it's just gonna happen.
Oh my God, we're not talking about your dad's
wiener.
He's gonna
feel so intimidated too.
No way, man. The doctor said it was. Totally okay for a boy my age.
It's totally normal.
It is funny that I was thinking about, like, I think that I could take Josh to the naked beach. I think I could take you. You'd be fine. But I don't take my clothes off, really. I mean, sometimes I do, but not like when I'm family's around. No.
Okay.
I don't.
What if you saw me there?
Just chilling.
Well, that would be different though, because you see me naked all the time.
Uh-huh.
I mean, not all the, like every day, but is it every day?
No,
not every day, but it's sometimes. Mm-hmm. So the thing is, they say about parenting is that this is what I read this once and I thought, oh, this is that's fucking good advice. Was that when the kids start acting weird? That you're naked, like, oh, mom, or, you know, whatever, they run away from you when you're naked or something like that. That means that they don't want to, like, you shouldn't put that in their fucking face anymore. So, but you guys, unfortunately, never acted that way. So I just never.
Well, because there's no reason to.
If it bothers you, you sure as shit don't tell me, huh?
Not a little idiot.
Well, I know, but even when you were a little idiot, you still didn't. React like that. It's never bothered you. Like, I used to try to go potty by myself. Can't. Josh would always come in. So you never.
Yeah, I like stopped doing that like last year or something. Like
yeah, just like yesterday.
Yeah.
I'm finally peeing alone. Thanks, guys.
You did it.
Yeah, and that's only when there's toilet paper.
just like 3 a.m, you just get in there, and then you just hear.
Mom,
are you going to pee in there?
can I just stand by you,
Mom? Are you popping a squat, Mom?
Can I come in?
Number one or number two, Mom?
Oh, gross.
I gotta know.
Oh, God. I'm so tired. I have to work in the morning. Okay, so Christopher, you were going to tell me about Bad Dragon.
I was telling Josh about this website earlier. Just letting him know.
Well, I know what it is.
What is it?
I'm sure there. I'm sure there are websites.
It's a website where you can procure items.
Items. So okay.
I want to say marital aids, but I know that nobody who buys that stuff has anyone in their life.
No. Okay.
What are you talking about?
Okay. So when you worked at the porn store, what mm-hmm. was the biggest dildo you ever had in stock?
It's called the Greatest American Challenge or something like that.
What shape was it? It was in like a penis shape, right?
Yeah.
Like a human penis.
Yeah.
Possibly.
But it was it was like this big. You guys, like, maybe, I don't know, what is that? Like the size of a baby's head?
Yeah.
Like, you know?
I fit a whole baby's head up my ass. Great. Cool, dude.
Yeah.
But I mean, it was like the circumference of like
a baby. Was it red, white,
and
blue?
A baby's head. No, it was purple, but the packaging was very patriotic.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
So Bad Dragon, as the name suggests, it sells.
Pretty naughty.
Naughty.
And also, it's
so dragon dildo, like dragon shaped dildos.
What?
Dragons
that are like pointy.
Not only dragons.
It doesn't just stop there. There's
horses.
Horse dicks, flared and unflared.
What?
When a horse gets like when a horse comes, its penis head goes woo like a flower and like goes out like a.
Shut up!
Like
really?
That, so it can't get out. So,
I'm amazed on both sides. I did not know that.
Yeah, I had to look that up.
That's why horses get stuck together.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
They have
okay.
to artificially inseminate. Anyway, mm-hmm. they sell like horse dicks and dog dicks.
What?
They sell dog dicks and dog
horse
vaginas.
Pussies,
horse.
Dog pussies.
Dragon pussies?
Dragon
probably.
Pussies. Dragon buttholes. Dragons aren't real. But they have like a wide array of dragon dicks.
They have like they
How
have
did
like
you
they
find
have
this
no they
place?
Have like ice dragons and fire dragons. I know that one that they have different
oh,
elemental
yeah.
dragons.
Have, yeah, they have different kinds
shadow
of
dragons.
Shadow dragons. Different sizes.
Okay, okay. It's,
the biggest ones. Oh, they this for some like they just have like suction cups and the people put them up on their walls and show off their collections.
What?
Yeah.
And that like the dragon dicks are like pointy. They're like all scaled and they got like
big.
They have a smog one.
That one's like the big one. Right?
I was very
upset. Smog one is like the huge one.
Like from
The Hobbit.
Yeah.
Like from the book.
Oh my God, this is stupid.
Yeah. Oh man.
Whoa.
They have like, yeah. Strap in. Anyway, so like
more like strap on.
Good
so
one,
like,
Josh.
It's a pretty popular thing to if you like somebody, but also you hate them and want to embarrass them in front of a lot of people, you will drop 200 bones on a dragon dildo and you'll mail it to
drop
their house.
Drop 200 bones on a dragon bone.
Yeah. And mail it, and have it mailed to their house. And they'll take like requests too. They'll be like, hey, do you want us to like put a note in there or something?
You want us to engrave gotcha on the tip of the dick and
adoptions? What's that?
It's just like dildos that are fucked up.
What?
It's like fucked up dildos. Like
there are what? How can they get any worse?
Well, they're molded wrong or something.
Oh. There's like two of them stuck together.
Hold on.
Double-ended dragon dildo. Just a football.
Adoptions. All of these toys are in stock and ready to ship. They usually have cosmetic defects and are heavily discounted. I see.
Still super
expensive. I don't know
why
they're called adoptions.
Well,
yeah.
Because each of the dildos has like a story behind it and like
a
name.
Yeah, they have lore.
See.
So this is like dildos for nerds?
For, I wouldn't say nerds, but
the fantasy inclined? The what? What is this?
Fucking grossos. I know someone.
I can see the artwork is stupid. Nice.
Yep. Dragons, like cool dragons.
Ooh.
Except they got boners, big drippy dicks.
Drippy.
Oh, Hans the Mandrake. That looks retarded. Bruiser the Fusion.
They sound like computer parts.
Right?
Bad dragon. Can we get a sponsorship from that?
Right.
I already suggest that.
That's a great idea.
I'd take their money. Absolutely.
I would also take their money.
This podcast brought to you by Bad Dragon. Get your dragon dick now.
And then we can have like a
put the fire in you. Ooh,
That's a good one.
Yeah, I sound great. Oh my God.
Hit them up on Twitter
today. Unflared horse cock. Yep, looking at it.
Big old horse dick. Look at the flared one.
Unflared Chance the Stallion. Okay. What is it? Wait. It's,
I don't know how you would get a flared one inside you. I can't even imagine that. You'd have to like go, get the lip in first.
Oh my God.
And then just kind of work it.
Like you're trying to get a couch through a small door.
Yeah.
Whoa.
What?
Oh, horse pussy.
Yep.
Ooh, does it have a clit? What is that?
I don't know, but like the horse pussy is
the
like
equine rump, Hazel the werewolf,
the horse,
JT the fox.
Yeah, you need to hit that shit.
What's that?
Hit that shit.
Yeah, silly. And is Duke a dog? Duke's butt.
Duke's butt.
Janine the dragoness. Oh, that pussy does look like a dragon's pussy. I mean, like if you had to imagine one, yeah, I guess it. Mm-hmm, I guess that's it.
None of these people had to imagine one.
Oh,
they
my
definitely
God.
Wanted to.
Wow. They've got like little cock socks for we can put on your wieners and make it like
look
werewolf
like a
wearable.
All of
that
is
for nerds.
All of the horse vaginas, there's like five different colors of them. And they're all in the colors of the My Little Pony main cast.
I can see that. That's
awesome.
Right? That is so great. This is finally.
They have
oh my
pie?
God, they've got them
Rainbow
where
Dash?
They squirt.
What?
Oh yeah, they have ones that are like have like a hole in the middle and then it comes with like a tube and a little pump and so you can just fill up.
Come
fill
lube
her up.
Clear.
Do they have like semen drip trays and
teeny weenies? Oh my God, this is so this is a weird.
Yeah, you don't want to be on there for too long.
I gotta go.
Probably
God. I don't know what these are.
We're going to have to edit so much of this out because like it's mostly just mom.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
When we
get
home, you can go on the computer and look them up.
Ugh.
You can see that shitty artwork in full HD.
You see the dragon. You can see the drip.
I've never seen a stupid dildo website before. Like, I mean, they're all kind of dumb, but, like, you know, they're like, wow, you need an extra dick in your vagina or butt. That's okay.
Need something to go in you?
Yeah, okay. We got that. They're very functional.
Need something
this is
to go in you that isn't real? Bad dragon got you.
Yeah.
You want your...
Yeah, I'm... listen, I'm looking for a dildo, but I need it to be of a chupacabra. I just have a fantasy about... Like, that's how I think the internet is ruining human sexuality, because it's just making us too weird.
I don't know anybody...
And too picky about stuff.
All my friends want to fuck robots and monsters. It's horrible.
I mean, it depends. It'd be cool, I guess.
Humping a robot?
Yeah, why not?
Just wait, aliens are going to come down to Earth, and they're going to be like, hey, what's up? And everyone's going to try and jump their bones. In like 100 years, everyone's going to be super gross and weird, and they're going to scare them away.
That's what happened in the Bible. Do you know this story? A bunch of angels, there was Sodom and Gomorrah, and that's why God wanted to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, because these angels showed up, and they were like, everybody goes, hey, let us fuck those dudes.
Get up in those sexy angels.
Well, they got to look good. They can't look bad. They got to be beautiful, right?
No, I mean the whole town showed up to fuck them.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then Lot was like, no, you can fuck my daughters, though.
Yeah, they're just women, but you can't have these angels.
You can't have these two angel dudes.
They're mine.
Speaking of My Little Pony, our producer, Mark Major, went to the bins.
Made quite a find.
Can we describe it, what he gave us? Where is it?
It's outside. It's a little bust of a pony so that you can... test out wigs for your waifu.
For your
fucking pony waifu.
What is a waifu?
It's wife in Japanese.
Yeah. Waifu.
Waifu.
Say it in a Japanese accent and you're like, oh.
Oh, I get it. Okay.
The male equivalent is husbando.
Shut up. Are you making that up?
No.
Husbando.
You don't know about the waifu?
No. I don't know anything about a waifu.
Every otaku-chan has a different waifu.
They go on their spirit quest.
They go on their spirit
waifu.
So they watch a really good anime with a really super hot anime chick.
Or maybe she just looks like a little girl.
Or maybe it's a little girl. Maybe
you never know.
A little girl with big bows and yeah.
Uh-huh. Go on.
And then they
she's very moe. Moe.
Very moe. and so they. So then they, jerk it sometimes at them. want them to be by their side.
So they get a Daki Kamura.
Yeah. They get body pillows.
It's called a Daki Kamura?
I'm sorry. They get Daki Kamura, a.k.a. body pillows, full-size pillows with the character embroidered onto the pillow so they can hug it. And
just like, you know, so they don't
feel like you do.
That cold darkness.
They can feel... You can feel Oni-chan's beautiful embrace while you fall asleep.
Do these pillows have like little holes that you can stick your
wing
in?
Oh yeah. I'm sure there are some that do.
Oh my God.
I mean they have like the rubber ones so you can probably. Oh, okay. So
she bought me a butt pillow.
You know the new Oculus Rift?
Yeah. The very first game for the Oculus Rift
was where you can have an anime character like sleep next to you,
and also you can fuck them, and it comes with
a rubber
fleshlight that is attached to the Oculus Rift, so that when stuff happens to your penis in the video game, it goes.
What?
Yeah, you didn't. I thought I told you about that.
Yeah, and
I could have sworn I hooted and hollered and laughed.
I
like videos of the dudes testing it. They're like, that's really funny. Like some Japanese guys. Hilarious. It's hilarious.
Wow.
And
okay,
it's just a video of like, it's just like they have the screen and it's just some anime girl bent over and that's it. And they can like do stuff.
It's got little gloves. So you can cop a feel.
Yeah. And you can just do whatever you want.
So weird.
Yeah.
They'll be
limitless potential,
or they'll be like the walking through your house.
The most immersive virtual reality system ever made
is about sex.
And the first game that it wasn't like the people who made the Oculus Rift made this game.
It was I mean that's the first thing that comes to mind, right? When you think, oh, we have this virtual reality where we can do anything. Maybe we should make some anime sex, dude. Yeah, let's do that.
Sex is one thing. There's like a bajillion other things that you could do.
Yeah, those come after the waifu.
Yeah.
After dipping that tip.
Once we perfect the waifu, we can perfect life.
Okay, so
virtual
then
life.
The waifu, explain the, okay, so this is, but back to Mark. Mark got us a little, he went to the bins and got us a little brony bust, or no.
Pony.
My Little Pony bust, and You can try out wigs on it.
You can try out different
wigs. The wig comes off and then it goes back on.
It's funny.
Mm-hmm. It's hilarious. And we got pictures of Josh kissing it, and with a fedora on. Why were you wearing a fedora, Josh?
Well, it's commonly suggested that the Reddit masters of the Brony subreddit wear fedoras and have neck beards. It's basically like this. Well, fedoras are cool. Hats, cool, quote unquote. And so, they wear them, and
it makes them look classy.
Because it makes them look classy, but but they're greasy and fat and love ponies. That's the
kicker. They don't wear nice suits with them.
They just wear
a fucking fedora.
They wear fedoras and their
wallet chain pants.
Yeah, big fat like this like big T-shirt that has Rainbow Dash on it, says 20% cooler, whatever the garbage human beings wear. I don't care.
So the reason producer Mark gave us the Brony bus or the My Little Pony bus is because the boys hate bronies. Those are the dudes. Okay, explain for people who are just tuning in. A Brony is
A full-grown man that enjoys My Little Pony
and jerks it.
Well, those are called cloppers.
And they're totally different.
They're totally different. No. Someone who...
Why aren't they different? Why aren't they different?
Well, because someone who... Okay, this is obviously extreme, but someone who watches child pornography doesn't actually touch them. They're not actually child molesters.
That's a great point, Josh.
Yep. They're just... Doesn't mean they're not weird. Well, because they say... Their arguments kind of go like this. It has great morals. It teaches
Little Pony.
It's not a kids show. It's a family show. Okay, and it's honestly really funny. It's funny.
No, it's not funny.
No, it's none of those things.
It's a shit show. It's the worst show.
It's a good show for little girls.
Little girls.
Yeah, I mean, but for anybody over
for
five,
a grown
it's stupid.
Ass man, it teaches good morals.
Like you should learn those. You should already know that friends are good. Friendship is magic. It's magic, yeah.
That's awesome.
I don't know how you can watch it honestly and be like,
that was really poignant. I really learned something.
It's so good.
Or like they're crying at the end of an episode.
I can't believe it. I can't believe Rainbow Dash learned so much that episode. I can't believe Pinkie Pie got out of that one.
Are these
so
the real
much.
Names?
Pinkie Pie, Rainbow Dash, Spike is a dragon.
He's a baby dragon,
he's
though, baby so he's,
dragon.
Not even cool.
Oh.
He's, like, a cute little baby dragon.
There's Derpy. Well, not really. Derpy is, like, this...
It's, like, a background character that have sideways
eyes.
I think
it's very funny that you guys retarded. Know the names. That's great.
Of course
you have to understand what you hate before you hate it, Mom.
Yeah, of course. There's Applejack.
No, I get
Applejack,
that, for sure.
Right? There's Applejack. I'm sure I'm missing a few. There's, like, the queen pony or whatever.
There's Twilight Sparkle.
Twilight.
That's the main character.
Twilight. I know about that
one,
yeah.
So My Little Pony, it started in, the 80s, right? And that was Gen 1. And it was all these same characters.
Right.
It's just, a recycled...
Yeah.
Q from The Next Generation plays a character on the show.
What? Really?
Yeah.
I mean, it's for a little kid. I don't have any problem with the show, because it's just a little kid. Like I fucking hate SpongeBob. It's stupid.
Right.
It's just a kid for it's just a show for little kids. And I have nothing wrong with that. It's just...
The people that like the show.
The
adults that like the show.
The adults that like the show. And
they're called bronies. And bronies. Are there women that like the show like that?
Yeah, they're called Pegasisters.
Ew.
But like...
All right.
They're not as gross. They're inherently not as gross. Because they're ladies who like a show for girls. And they're not coming on their figurines.
That
gross!
Happens, yeah.
They jerk off on the figurines?
Probably. I bet.
Should
that's
we
what
DNA
that...
test that?
Yeah, that bus is probably so that you can just dry it off. Dry off one of your little wigs.
Gross.
God.
Okay, you guys, what else are we going to talk about this episode?
That was everything I had.
That's it? Josh, you got anything? Josh just spent a week at his dad's and was at his friend.
We were at Shasta.
Oh, yeah. We went to Lake Shasta with... my aunt and Uncle Bob and the rest of the family. That was kind of nice. That was fun.
Listen to listen to some good music while you were down there?
A familiar
jam, perhaps?
In one of our episodes, we talk about how we hate these country muddin' songs.
I don't hate it.
I actually love it. It is novel.
I'm glad it exists. I'm definitely happy.
It's pretty weird. Okay, so my uncle, our Uncle Bob, organically on his own, fell in love with one of these Mudden songs. Like, you know, it's the rappy one that goes, "This is how we roll." That one?
Yeah. With those three dudes that look like the same fat dude with the backwards cap.
Yes, that's it. And we listened to that 100 times. It was crazy.
Sounds like a great time.
There was the one that
was about the dude who was driving his wife's old truck. I drive your truck.
Never.
I tear it up till all the pain's a cloud of dust.
That one got played a few times too. Oh god, but it was fun. Josh got on the what the fuck were you on?
Karaoke.
Oh yeah, that was the best part. Okay, so Josh actually sang karaoke the boat for the first time ever. I've never seen him do. I don't know if you've ever sang karaoke before.
No, I've never done that.
Okay, so, but he was amazing. He sang Paradise by the Dashboard. No, Bat Out of Hell. He sang Bat Out of Hell with Jenny. And he sang
In the Summertime by Mungo
Jerry. It was great. He actually put on a hat and glasses and did the whole, like, go ahead, Josh, give us a little line.
No.
Do it.
What? In the Summertime?
You can cut it out. I've never heard you sing.
He's really good. He's really, really good. Josh, you do
it. No, I'm just good at impersonating people's voices.
No, well, then you were really good.
This dude's voice.
Oh, Mungo Jerry?
Yeah, you can cut it out. I don't care.
Yeah, just edit it out, but just let me hear it. It was really good.
You could just play a clip of Mungo Jerry, and people would be like, whoa, that dude's really
good. He's really good.
How did he make all these chart sounds, too?
Have you ever heard Mungo Jerry? Have you ever heard the song?
Yeah.
We want to hear you do it, though.
I don't want to.
But you can edit it out. You're going to be fucking in charge of this, so just do it. In the summertime,
do you not want Mark to hear?
No.
Are you afraid he's going to laugh at you?
You're embarrassed to sing in front of Mark?
Yeah.
Mark doesn't judge you.
That's it.
Mark doesn't judge
you. You guys got it. You guys did it.
But Josh is just a coward.
Josh, you're in a safe place.
Yeah, I know. I know I can't be hurt, I'm feeling attacked.
All right, fine. You guys, we got to get this shit out of here because I have to go to work in the morning.
Fantastic.
You know,
I wish I could go to work. That'd be totally
something to do. He doesn't have a computer.
I don't have anything. I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to go home and I'm going to commit suicide.
You got that DS. You can play video games.
You can use my computer.
Ooh, awesome. That sounds awesome.
You're welcome.
You can.
I could also use a calculator. Because it's about the same thing.
Ouch, 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 ouch. Okay, well, we've gotten off to a little lackluster start, I think, for our new season of Levine Large. We're doing the best we can.
It was definitely funnier than nothing.
Right? So you're welcome, question mark? I feel like, yeah. All right, we knocked it out of the park, guys. Good job. Yay, us.
We showed up.
Yeah, Sabrina couldn't be here tonight because she had to work. She's working at Winco, which, you know what, you guys? She will probably retire there. That's amazing.
Yeah, that's a good, she got a good position.
What is she doing at Winco?
No, she's working at Winco.
I'd love to work at Winco.
Yeah, she's working her butt off at Winco. She's doing great.
Did she get on there as a Siri or as a Levine?
A Siri.
Nice. That means she could get a recommendation. Just say, oh, it's my friend.
Oh, that's right. Good point.
Yeah.
I thought you were like, great, she's the only Arab person that works at Winco. Great, a Siri, they won't think she's Mexican. Awesome.
Right? Also that.
I guess.
She's not going to make any friends while she's working at cash register.
No.
She's going to get spit on.
Ooh, Winco is so nice because you don't have to bag anything when you're working the thing, because I hate bagging.
No, it's great. This is why I say that she could retire there, because it's like employee owned or whatever. Anyway, they've got good benefits. Anyway, so Sabrina couldn't be here tonight because she had to work.
She has a really good job.
And she has a great job and she's really happy. And she'll tell us about, I can't wait to hear about this, but she'll tell us next week about how her and her boyfriend had to put down his childhood dog.
Oh, boy.
It's a great story. She'll tell us that next week. Okay, you guys, let's go to bed. I got to go to bed. I love you. I love you. I love you.
Love you, too.
Yep. Yeah.
I'm not talking to you.
I missed you so much while you were gone, by the way.
That's awesome.
Whatever. Okay. All right. Bye.
Josh feels
sign off.
Validated.
And thank you for listening. Levine Large, brought to you by Island Station Media Labs. Producer, Mark Major. Theme song by Chris Shattuck.